This part of Unit Number 5 HVDC Transmission describes the comparison of high voltage DC transmission and extra high voltage AC transmission based on number of factors. Apart from that, it also includes few limitations of high voltage DC transmission systems. Let us begin with the comparison of AC and DC transmission. The comparison between these two types of transmission must be done based on the three factors. The first one is economics of power transmission, which states that how much cost effective the power transmission is. The next is technical performance, which transmission system is best technically. And the third one is the reliability, whether AC transmission is more reliable or the DC transmission is more reliable. So these are the key factors for the comparison between AC and DC transmission system. The first one, economics of power transmission. The DC transmission of bulk power over long distance has certain advantages over convention AC power transmission. In DC transmission, inductor and capacitor of the line has no effect on power transfer capacity of line and line drop. No leakage or charging current of the line under the steady state condition. The cost of terminal equipment is more in DC lines than in AC lines. So the cost comparison between AC and the DC transmission system is made in these graphs. The total cost of the transmission is divided into three parts. The first part is the terminal cost, which is also known as the substation cost. The second part of the cost is the line cost, cost corresponding to the cables. And the third cost is related to the losses. If you observe the graph, then on the x-axis we have the distance parameter and on the y-axis we have the cost parameter. And in this graph, at this point, you can see that the cost of DC transmission system and the cost of AC transmission system is same. So that corresponding distance is known as the break-even distance. By comparing these two curves, we can summarize that for the distance below the break-even distance, AC is more cost-effective. And for the distance greater than the break-even distance, the DC system is more cost-effective. So if the length of the line is greater than 400 km, then DC transmission system is much better as far as the cost is concerned. But for distance less than the 400 km, then AC transmission system is much better. In AC transmission system, the AC terminal cost is less than the DC terminal cost. As I said earlier, the terminal cost is the substation cost. The second cost, which is the line cost, that is more in AC system compared to the DC system. And the third type of the cost, which is due to the losses, that is much more in AC system compared to the DC system for the distance greater than the break-even distance. So the break-even distance is the distance at which the cost of AC transmission system and the cost of DC transmission system becomes same. But beyond the break-even distance, DC is better, and below the break-even distance, AC is better. These are the summary points of these graphs. The cost subdivision for a typical 2000 megawatt HVDC scheme. If we want to set up an HVDC transmission system to transmit 2000 megawatt of power, then the entire project cost gets divided into different parts. From this cost subdivision, you can observe that the valves portion is the costliest part in HVDC scheme. After the valves, the converter transformer, 16% of the entire project cost. Thereafter, civil works, buildings, 14%. Thereafter, AC filters, other equipments, and the engineering works. After that, election and commissioning 8%. Control part is of 7%, and at last, the freight insurance is of 5%. So from these all divisions, you can see that the most costliest part in the HVDC system is the valves and the converter transformer. Moving ahead, the next parameter is the technical performance. The full control over the power transmitted in either direction. We can control the magnitude of the power as well as the direction of the power which is being transmitted from one location to another location. The ability to improve the transient and the dynamic stability of AC system when embedded with the DC link. The fast control to limit the fault currents in DC lines. A DC link can be used as an asynchronous tie which can tie down the small variation in system frequency of the different systems. I have explained the meaning of asynchronous tie in the part number 1. So when we want to connect two different systems having the various frequencies at that time, we can go with this HVDC concept. Only two conductors per circuit rather than three conductors if we talk about the bipolar HVDC scheme. Thereafter, towers carry less conductor weight, so the size as well as the weight of the towers become less. Thereafter, reliability. HVDC is more reliable because during the fault it supplies at least 50% power. That we have understood in bipolar and homopolar HVDC scheme. Stability of the power system. The power transfer capacity remains same throughout the distance in DC system, whereas in the case of AC system it is not the same. Corona, radio interference and skin effect. The corona loss and the radio interference are lower in DC when we operate the HVDC link with the negative polarity. There is no skin effect in the conductor of a DC system because there is no frequency in DC parameters. Cable for underground or sea transmission. So DC cables are subjected to less overcurrent stresses compared to AC cables. With same conductor size, the power transmitted in DC is about 2.5 times that with the AC. So the power transmission capacity in the case of DC cable is much more higher than with the AC cable for same conductor size. Limitations of HVDC system. Due to the generation of harmonic in the converter operation at the sending end side rectifier and at the receiving end inverter, the non-sinusoidal current will flow in the converter transformer in the AC side, causing audio frequency telephone interference. Huge filters are required on both AC and DC sides to suppress the harmonics. In the line diagram, we have seen the AC filters which are connected to the AC bus and DC filters after the smoothing reactor to eliminate the higher order harmonics. So huge filters are required on both AC as well as the DC sides. Reliable multi-terminal DC systems are yet to be established because there is no HVDC circuit breakers available. Complexity of the control. To control the magnitude as well as the direction of the power, we have to control many equipments in the HVDC system, and to control all the equipments in the synchronism manner, that is the biggest difficult task of HVDC system. So the control is little bit complex. Highest cost of the conversion equipment. As we saw in the previous slide, that most costliest part in HVDC transmission system project is the valves. Valves are nothing but the thyristors or IGBTs which we are using for construction of rectifier or inverter. So high cost of the conversion equipment, that is the limitation of HVDC system. Instability to use the transformers to change the voltage levels. And more maintenance is required in AC parts of HVDC system Apart from that, not economical for short distance. That also we understood in the previous slide that for distance less than the break-even distance, the AC system is far better than the DC as far as the cost parameter is concerned. So for the short distance, HVDC system is not preferable. So these are the limitations of HVDC system. Now let us do the comparison between extra high voltage AC transmission link with high voltage DC transmission link based on the number of parameters. The first one is the power transferability. The power transfer capacity in extra high voltage AC link is lower. It is also limited by power angle and the reactance. But in the case of HVDC, the power transfer capacity is high. But sometimes it is limited by the temperature rise of the equipments. Control of the power flow in AC transmission system, the control of power flow is slow and difficult, whereas in the case of DC transmission system, we can control the power flow very fast, accurate and bidirectionally. The frequency disturbance in AC system is high as well as the communicated between the system. But in the case of DC, the frequency disturbance is less. The transient performance of AC link is very poor, but the transient performance of HVDC link is excellent. The power swing, which is also known as the power variations, oscillations, it continues for longer time in AC system, but that power oscillations are damped quickly in HVDC system by the control units. Fault levels in extra high voltage AC link, the fault levels get added after the interconnection. When two or more systems are interconnected, then the fault levels are added. But in the case of HVDC link, it remains unchanged after the interconnection. The frequency conversion in AC link is not possible, but in the case of HVDC, we can change the frequency. Number of the conductors in extra high voltage AC link, if we consider one circuit of three phase system, then three conductors are used, hence higher volume of the conductor material is required. But in the case of HVDC, if we talk about the bipolar link, then only two conductors are required. So remarkable saving is obtained in the conducting material. What about the stress on the insulator? It is very high in AC link, but it is very low in DC link. About the corona effect, it is present and it also creates the interference with the surrounding communication lines. But in the case of HVDC, the corona is absent. Skin effect and the Ferranti effect, these both effects are present in AC link, but these both effects are absent in DC link. What about the substation maintenance? The substation maintenance is very easy in extra high voltage AC link, but it is very difficult in HVDC because in DC link, the substation is made up of converter valves. Simplicity of the line in AC link, it is little bit complicated, but in the case of DC, it is very simple. Voltage regulation is poor in AC because of the capacitive and inductive reactance both are present into the system. Whereas in the DC link, these capacitive and inductive reactance are absent, because of that we can have the better regulation. Reactive power loss is present in AC link, whereas in the case of DC, reactive power is absent because there is no frequency in DC link. Overload capacity of AC system is very high, but for DC system, the overload capacity is limited because of the converter ratings. Power factor lagging because net reactance is present, which is mostly inductive, whereas the power factor of the HVDC link is unity. About overall stability of the system, overall stability of the system, AC link is less stable, less reliable, but DC link is more stable and more reliable. Intermediate substation in AC link, intermediate substation is required at every 300 meter distance for the compensation of the reactive power, but in the case of DC, there is no need of intermediate substation.